to date, the Three Gorges project is the largest hydro junction in the world. It is the key project for the integrated water resources management and development of the Changjiang River. The technology of the project, with its huge scale and comprehensive benefits, is extremely complicated, and the world design difficulty is greater than that of any other hydro project in the world. Dams in themselves are engineering and construction marvels that use the flow of water predominantly for irrigation and generating hydroelectricity. The Three Gorges Dam in China is by far the largest hydroelectric plant on earth, but it is not without controversy. While it certainly looks like an engineering masterpiece, there are few things you may not have known. We take a look at the good, the bad, and the ugly truth behind this man-made marvel. Three Gorges Dam, dam of the Yangtze River, just west of the city of Yichang in Hubei Province, China. When construction of the dam officially began in 1994, it was the largest engineering project in China. At the time of its completion in 2006, it was the largest dam structure in the world. The dam and accompanying hydroelectric plant were built in phases and over the course of many years. It reached its fully generating capacity in 2012. The dam allows the navigation of ocean-going freighters and generates hydroelectric power. It was also intended to provide protection from floods, but efficacy on this point is unclear and has been debated. Physical description and capacity of the Three Gorges Dam. A straight crystal concrete gravity structure, the Three Gorges Dam is 2,335 meters long with a maximum height of 185 meters. It incorporates 28 million cubic meters of concrete and 463,000 metric tons of steel onto its design. Submerging large areas of the Kutang Wu and Xiling Gorges for some 600 km upstream, the dam has created an immense deep water reservoir, allowing ocean-going freighters to navigate 2,250 km inland from Shanghai on the East China Sea to the inland city of Chongqing. Navigation of the dam and reservoir is facilitated by the 5-tier ship locks at both the ends of the complex, which allows vessels of up to 10,000 tons to navigate past the dam, and a ship lift, which allows vessels up to 3,000 tons to bypass the ship locks and travel past the dam more quickly. At the time of completion in late 2015, the lift, which was 120 meters long and 18 meters wide and 3.5 meters deep, was the largest ship lift in the world. Limited hydroelectric power production began in 2003 and gradually increased as additional turbine generators came online over the years until 2012, when all the dam's 32 turbine generator units are operating. Those units, along with two additional generators, gave the dam the capacity to generate 22,500 megawatts of electricity, making it the most productive hydroelectric dam in the world. In 2020, the hydroelectric plant produced 111.88 kilowatt hours, setting a new world record for annual power generation volume. Engineering to the extreme. While the Three Gorges Dam has attracted negative attention, there are also some really positive benefits. It was essentially made with three main purposes in mind: flood control, hydroelectric power production, and navigation improvement. The dam was also intended to protect millions of people from the periodic flooding that plagues the Yangtze Basin, although just how effective it has been in this regard has been debated. In 2020, China experienced its heaviest flood in more than three decades. The dam's reservoir neared maximum capacity, reaching the highest level since it began retaining water in 2003. Officials said that dam reduced damage and loss of life from the floods, while critics asserted that the heavy floods served to highlight the limitation of the dam as an effective flood control tool. It solves one big problem, which is keeping the river at bay during the flooding season. It helps protect millions of people downstream, including important cities adjacent to Yangtze, such as Wuhan, Tianjin, and Shanghai. The reservoir that the dam creates measures an area around 505 square miles, which is pretty impressive. History and controversy of the Three Gorges Dam. First discussed in the 1920s by Chinese Nationalist Party leaders, the idea for the Three Gorges Dam was driven by impetus in 1953 when Chinese leader Mao Zedong ordered feasibility studies of number of sites. Detailed planning for the project began in 1955. Its proponents insisted it would control disastrous flooding along the Yangtze, facilitate inland trade, and provide much-needed power for central China. But the dam was not without its detractors. Criticism of the Three Gorges Dam project began as soon as the plans were proposed and continued through its construction. Key problems, including the danger of the dam collapse, the displacement of 1.3 million people living in more than 1,500 cities, towns, and villages along the river, and the destruction of magnificent scenery and countless rare architectural and archaeological sites. There were also some fears, some of which were borne out, that human and industrial waste from the cities would pollute the reservoir, and even that the huge amount of water impounded in the reservoir could trigger earthquake and landslides. Some Chinese and foreign engineers argued that a number of smaller and far cheaper and less problematic dams on the Yangtze tributaries could generate as much as power as the Three Gorges Dam and control flooding equally well. Construction of those dams, they maintained, would enable the government to meet its main priorities without the risks. Because of these problems, work on the Three Gorges Dam was delayed for nearly 40 years as the Chinese government struggled to reach a decision to carry through with plans for the project. In 1992, Premier Li Peng, who had himself trained as an engineer, was finally able to persuade the National People's Congress to ratify the decision to build the dam, though almost a third of its members abstained or voted against the project, an unprecedented sign of resistance from a normally acquiescent body. President Jiang Zemin did not accompany Li to the official inauguration of the dam in 1994, and the World Bank refused to advance China funds to help in with the project. Nevertheless, the Three Gorges project moved ahead. In 1993, work started on access roads and electricity to the site. Workers blocked and diverted the river in 1997, bringing to a close the first phase of construction. In 2003, the reservoir began to fill. The five-tier ship locks, which allowed vessels of up to 10,000 tons to navigate past the dam, were put into preliminary operation, and the first of the dam's generators was connected to the grid, completing the second phase of construction. Following completion of this second phase, some 200 sites of historical and archaeological importance that was once lined the middle reaches of the Yangtze River vanished as floodwaters rose. Construction of the main wall of the dam was completed in 2006. The remainder of the dam's generators were operational by mid-2012, and shiplift, which allowed vessels up to 3,000 tons to bypass the five-tier ship locks and more, quickly navigate past the dam, was completed in late 2015 and began officially operating in 2016. So this was it for the world's largest dam, the Three Gorges Dam. If you enjoyed this video, then please don't forget to like button and make sure you subscribe for more such content. Thanks for watching. We will see you in the next video.